Hello guys, and welcome to C programming tutorials by Amul's Academy. We were discussing about data type in C, and in the previous tutorial we discussed about void and character data type. Today we'll discuss about int, float and double data type in C. So first we'll talk about the int data type. This data type allows a variable to store numeric value, integer value. So here int stands for integer. So the size of this data type is 2-byte, 4-byte or 8-byte. It depends on the processor and compiler. If size of int is 2-byte, then we can store the values of this range in the variable. So that is nothing but the value from -2^15 to 2^15 - 1. The formula to find out the range is nothing but -2^n-1 to +2^n-1 - 1. So 2-byte is nothing but 16 bits. So here n is nothing but 16. So n minus 1, that is nothing but 16 - 1, that is 2^15. So here 2^n-1 - 1, that is nothing but 2^15 - 1. The range is this for 2-byte. For the 4-byte, that is nothing but 32 bits. So 2^31 - 2^31 to +2^31 - 1. This is the range. The values belong to this range can be stored in the variable. For example, int age. So age is a variable here. I'm using integer data type here. That means we can store the integer value in this variable. So next, initializing the variable, we can take like this. Okay, we can store the integer value in this variable. So in the integer data type, we can store the integer value. The storage size of int data type is 2-byte, 4-byte or 8-byte. Okay, so this is about the int data type. Next, we'll discuss about float and double data type. These two data types comes under floating point data types. So first, we'll talk about the float. So this float data type allows a variable to store decimal values. For example, this value, this contains decimal part, right? To store these values in a variable, we need a data type. So for that, we can use float data type. If I use int data type, it will remove the decimal part and it only print 59. It will remove 0.34. To print the exact value, we can use the float data type. So the storage size of float is 4-byte. You can store integer value in the float data type variable. For example, 67. So it will store that like this. It will represent the integer value in the floating point form. So while declaring the variable, if I want to store decimal value in any variable, then I need to take type of that variable as float. For example, I can take like this, float height, and I can take value as 5.4, like this. So this is about the float data type. Next, we'll talk about the double data type. Double data type also allows us to store decimal value in the variables, but double has wider range. Double is 8-byte, which means you can have more precision than float. Float is single precision data type. Double is double precision data type. In the computation, when we get the longer value or the bigger value with the more digits after decimal point, then to store that value in the variable, we can take type of that variable as double. Okay, so this is about the float and double data type. So we discussed about the five data types: void, character, int, float and double. Void means nothing, no value. Usually we will use void with the functions. Next, character data type, which allows a variable to store single character. The size of the character data type is 1-byte. Integer data type, which allows a variable to store integer values. The size of int data type is 2-byte, 4-byte or 8-byte. Next, float data type, which allows a variable to store decimal value. Size of float is 4-byte. Next, double data type. Double data type is also similar to float data type, which allows a variable to store decimal value. But float is the single precision data type. Double is the double precision data type. So if you want to store the larger value or bigger value with the decimal point, then you can use double data type. So in the next class, we'll discuss about the data type modifiers. So that's it for now, guys. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. I will meet you in next class. Till then, take care.